Hi guys, and welcome to another one of my videos. Apologies that I've not uploaded anything for a while. The reason for that is, so since my last video, I have been in two competitions and I have done absolutely rubbish. So the reason why I've not been flying for the last like 2-3 weeks is, to be honest, I've been sulking because I've not performed how I've liked. So obviously I've been putting all this practice in the gym and on the field and stuff, been flying pretty well, consistency is getting better, my speed's getting better, smoothness is getting better, and then it comes to an event and it all goes to shit. Sorry for the language. So that is the reason why I've not been flying, because I've just lost a bit of my mojo really. But I'm back at it. I'm quite excited because, as you've seen on Facebook and that, I've recently just built one of these, which is a Raging Droner from Catalyst Machine Works. I've not flown it yet. This is going to be my first flight today. So before I actually fly it, I just wanted to quickly like talk to you about the frame, basically, and the components and stuff that I'm using on it. So I'll quickly move to a close-up now so I can explain better and talk to you about the frame. So here we have it then, the Raging Droner by Catalyst Machine Works. It is a 5-inch frame, but can swing your bigger 5-inch props, so your 5.2s, 5.1s, 5.2s. The arms are 5mm thick. These braces are 4mm thick. So there's plenty of strength there. It feels very, very strong, this frame, to be honest. I don't feel like I'm going to break it pretty much straight away. Well, I hope not anyway. If you're familiar with Catalyst Machine Works, this is basically a crazy love child of like free frames. The smooth operator, the massive droner, and the America. So yeah, it's just basically taking the best parts from those three frames and mashing them into this. That is pretty much all I'm gonna say about the frame. I don't wanna waffle on too much, but I'll quickly obviously say what I'm using in the frame. So for the 4-in-1, I'm using the Hobbywing 60 amp. I've been using it for a few months now. Very good at ESC. They've just actually announced that they're gonna be releasing the actual retail version of it. So if you can get one, definitely get one. It's been holding up very well for me so far, and I like to crash and stuff. So yeah, the FC I'm using, I've been using it for a year or so, is the Sailor Racing FRS. Very, very good FC. I don't know why it's not more popular with the beta flight pilots, especially here in the UK, because it's quite easy to get hold of as well. Cheap, I think it's like £27. Yeah, flies really nice, solid, durable. Well, for the most part anyway, I'd say the only bad thing about it is, see this JST and sometimes the USB as well, they like to pop off. So what I do now is I just add a bit of clear epoxy to those connectors, and I've not had a problem since. So if you are thinking about getting one, just do that and it should be sound. I'm using the, probably can't see it, but it's tucked away in there. I'm using the Unify Pro 32 Nano. It's the first time I've using this VTEC, to be honest. I've been using the V1 version, so we'll see how that is. It should be all right. Obviously using Crossfire. I've got my Crossfire there and my Immortal T at the back there, which is nice and protected. Cause a lot of time these get frayed and stuff, but I think I've mounted it pretty well this time. Motors I'm using are the T-Motor F60 Pro V3 1750 kV, so I'm obviously on 6S. And sorry, I forgot to mention, the camera up at the front is the Runcam Racer 2. It's the first time I'm using that camera as well. I've heard good things about it, so I've been using the Sparrow 2, I think it is, a purple one. So yeah, that is pretty much it about the frame. I know I've not said loads, but I don't want to waffle on too much. If there's anything, obviously, you want to know, I can answer you in the comments. So I'm going to go into some flight footage now, but I'll quickly I'll tell you about the track that I'm going to be flying. Literally took me about, I'm by myself today. And it's taken me a good hour and a half to set up this track, so hopefully I don't break all my quads straight away, because I'll be gutted. But yeah, I'll just talk to you now about the track, and then we'll get into some flight footage. So here we have the start-finish gate. I'm actually going to go clockwise today. Usually the whole tracks, if anybody that's been here, if you've noticed, they're always anti-clockwise, so I'm going to go clockwise today. So yeah, got start finish here, you come through, then this one here is a split S, come round through to this gate on the left here, through corkscrew, and I'll just walk down so you can see better, corkscrew through this gate, then there's four flags here, so we're going round this one, round, so it's slalom basically, so round that end flag, swirling round, dropping down into that gate, coming through that gate, sweep around to the right, through this hoop, then we're going to go increase our altitude slightly, up through this hoop here, then we're going to come round to the right, round these three flags, once you pass this third flag here, through this gate, slight sweeper to the right, then there's three flags there, we're gonna hop over those, come round, drop into this gate, and then all the way back to the start finish. So yeah, that's the track. So now I'm gonna snap to some race footage. I might do some stick cam overlay as well if I can bother to set up my chest cam, but yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed the video so far and you enjoy the flight footage. Like I said, if there's anything you want to know about the frame, I know it was a quick spiel about it basically. I can talk to you more about it if you want to find out more. But yeah, thanks for watching and hope you enjoy the video, and if you want to like, subscribe, do all that good stuff, feel free. Leave a negative comment, whatever you want to do. Yeah, but whatever floats your boat. But yeah, thanks for watching and I shall see you in a bizzle. Peace. Here we go, guys. Raging drone, DVR, and a bit of stick over there. Sorry about the flickering, there's something wrong with this brand new Nano Pro 32 VTX shy thing, but still flyable, so let's go. This frame's sick! Ah, oh, sag. Thank you. That'll do. Hopefully that was alright for you guys, and hopefully my sticks are actually, I think they are, are in view. Yeah, hopefully you enjoyed that, and thanks for watching. See you in a bit.